Hello, beautiful animals. I hope this Monday is treating you well. Took the day off yesterday to recoup after I got home from the shadow work training. And happy to be back, happy to be back into the groove of things. And I did pull the cards yesterday, so I've been chewing on what came up. Kind of interesting. In the contrast of the two animals that showed up. So the first one that I pulled was the shark. Whoops, there we go. And hi, Nilima. Hi, Maitri. And so I've already done a meditation with... Okay, good. I'm still in live. I was getting a call in. I didn't know what was happening. Because we've already... spent some time with shark, I pulled a second card, and that what came up was hummingbird. And I happen to have this glorious hummingbird painting by my friend Ryan, so I decided to hang out in front of this for the meditation. And we have a lot of hummingbirds. I see hummingbirds almost every day now where we live, and they are so just like amazing in the way that they will really interact with each other. You know, they're like these tiny little birds, but they can be rather fierce when they're defending like their flower bush or whatever, wherever their nectar is that they've identified, like this is mine. And so it's a little comical because they're so small and so cute, but witnessing them almost every morning when we walk Leon, how they're tiny but fierce. I really have been getting that message from them lately. So without further ado, let's go inward and see what these two animals have for us. Go ahead and lower your eyes and take a couple nice deep breaths. And we're gonna come first into connection with shark. And so this is an animal that, you know, is living in the water. It can be rather large, larger than humans, depending on the species. And, you know, there's a lot around sharks, a lot of fear that humans hold towards sharks, a lot of mystery, the unknown about, you know, if sharks are going to be in the water when you might be in the water and what might happen. And so just for a moment, feel the contrast of the energy of shark, which, you know, is this embodiment of power and, you know, sort of being the top of the food chain in the ocean a lot of times. And contrast that with the energy of the hummingbird. This is an animal that lives in the air. Primarily, that is certainly not a predator in the way that a shark is, but it's still receiving the food chain, the supply of nectar from flowers. And in that way, it's, as I said, you know, having to kind of defend its, you know, these are my flowers. You can have that bush over there, but these ones here are mine. And hummingbird medicine really is about, you know, receiving that nectar of life, the joy, the playfulness, the sweetness. No matter how small you are, or how small you feel you are, that there is a lot in the world around you ready to be received. And so as you feel these two animals, the shark and the hummingbird, and how different they are, they're really quite, you know, we could keep listing things that are different about them, between them. But I want you to really feel into how sacred both these animals truly are, how they both play their part in their ecosystems, in the world. So if you picture out in front of you a shark and a hummingbird for a moment, just sort of feel them in front of you, and then let your heart open to both. Allow your heart to start to feel love towards both of them in the ways that they're different, where they live, how they live. That they're both sacred, both important, both worthy of love. And feel if in that love that you can send, you know, a little bit of sweetness, even to the shark. A little bit of gratitude. And honor. Like, hey, I see you both. And you can start to envision through your heart, you can pull from behind your heart and through your heart, emerald green light. This beautiful, vibrant, shimmery light. And you can allow that light to fill your heart. And then send a river of it towards the heart of the shark and the heart of the hummingbird. And as you breathe into sending this flow of love out to both these animals, you can ask, what is the message that you have for me today? What is showing up and tuning into this meditation in this moment? What is here for me? What is wanting to be seen right now for me? And so you may receive a message from shark or hummingbird or both. Perhaps you receive a message about the contrast between the two. And as you're sending the love out the front of your heart, you're just sort of inviting in. It's an invitation for information, the consciousness of these two animal totems to send a message in back to the front of your heart. And then whatever is coming through, when you feel complete, you're welcome to stay here longer. And if you're ready to close, you can thank both shark and hummingbird. And you can flicker your eyes open and come back into the room that you're in. And I am so grateful for you choosing to come on this little journey. And I hope that there was something here for you to explore. And I would love it and appreciate it if you found this meditation or others that I've done useful, to like and share and all that jazz. You can click see first on my profile too if you want to be able to catch every one of these as they come out each week. And if you have any questions, post them below. I'd love to be able to engage around any questions or if anything came up for you at all during this that you'd like to share. Go ahead and share it. I'd love to see the comments on this. And have a wonderful day. Thanks for tuning in. Lots of love.
Good job, buddy.